Hi sellers, welcome to SalesOS YouTube channel. So in this video, I'm going to discuss about offshore fourth engineers. Nowadays, it's very tough to get jobs in mainfleet even after class or COC also. So what you have to do? To join offshore vessels after class or COC, it is recommended or not? If recommended, what vessel you have to prefer? If you sail in offshore vessel, can you give class 4, class 2, class 1 COC or not? So I'm going to discuss about all of these topics regarding fourth engineer in offshore. Let's go into the video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and click the bell icon. First of all, I will say about my sea service. I started my career in offshore vessels only. I passed out BE Marine in 2015. I went to Mumbai to search job. I didn't get job anywhere. I searched every company. I searched a job for 3 months in Mumbai. It's very tough to get. No one is not proper responding. And I searched both offshore and mainfleet companies, everything. And finally, I got selected in one offshore vessel, that is non-DP Aegis. So I started with that vessel only. After 6 months service in STME, I did my MU class 4 in Chennai. After my class 4 COC, I tried to get job in mainfleet, but I didn't get. More than 6 months, 7 months, I waited after my class 4 COC. By luck only, my company called back me to join same Aegis non-DP vessels as a fourth engineer. After I sailed as fourth engineer in this vessel, how I joined in DP vessels, that I'm going to tell you. So before that, the main thing is there is no fourth engineer in foreign going offshore vessels. So how we will get job in offshore vessels as fourth engineer? So what to do? Because in offshore DP vessels, there is only third engineer. Only in India have fourth engineer. I don't know why they are still giving fourth engineer rank, because after class 4 in Indian DP vessels, they are not giving independent watch for fourth engineer. And also they are giving very less salary. See, some companies giving only 15,000, 35,000, 40,000, and some guys are working without salary also to get DP experience. But after class 4, it's very tough to get job in DP vessels. Only some companies giving opportunities. By luck, if you get job in DP vessels after your class 4, better join. It is no problem if you get job in non-DP also, but don't join in harbor tugs. Better always prefer DP vessel or non-DP ASTS. So try to take minimum 6 month experience as fourth engineer in offshore DP vessels, and after that you apply for foreign going companies. But if you mention fourth engineer in your resumes, they will not upset your CV. So try to search job for third engineer in offshore vessels, because there is no fourth engineer in offshore vessels. So try to search job for third engineer in offshore vessels. So just change your rank in your resume and try to apply in all offshore companies. Definitely you will get some reply from anyone companies. I already made one video about offshore shipping companies, email ID and contact numbers. That video link in the description, please check it. So for appearing class 4 COC, you required only 750 kilowatt and above. This 750 kilowatt you will definitely will get in offshore vessels. So after your 6 months service in offshore vessels, you can do boiler course and you can appear for class 4 exam. Same for second engine. Second engine required 3000 kilowatt. In offshore DP vessel, there is more than 2 engines only. So you will get definitely more than 3000 kilowatt. And in my vessels, it is around 12000 kilowatt. So it is more enough to give exams. Same for class 1 COC also, you can give class 4, class 2, class 1 with offshore DP vessel experience also. And don't do DP maintenance course. First you take minimum 6 month experience. After you get minimum 6 month experience, 4th engineer or 3rd engineer, whatever, after that only you do DP maintenance course. Okay guys, if you like this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. See you, bye bye.